Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.3.1 Developer Beta 3. This came in at around 136.1 megabytes on my 11 Pro Max, and similarly sized on the iPhone XR, the iPhone 6S Plus, and the iPad Pro from 2018. And this is also going to be available to public beta testers. If you're not seeing it by the time of this video, expect it a little bit later or the following day. But usually by the time I make a beta video, it's already out. So it may be out for you at this time. Now, the other thing is, this particular update is a very small update. It's 0.1, and we expected there to be a final already. So let's take a look at the build number, and we'll talk about what's new in this particular update. The build number is 17D5050A. And with this particular update, with the last letter being an A, we're very close to release. We're only 6 versions newer than the previous beta. And Apple usually has a bunch of internal updates. So sometimes they're 15 versions new and then they push it to the public. So we don't see every single update they do. They push a certain amount of them when they feel they're finished enough for testing. So this one's about 6 versions newer than the previous one. And it's surprising that Apple did not push out a final version. So we may see that soon. I'll talk about that later in the video. Now, as far as anything new is concerned, well, the notes only mention one thing, and that's for developers and an issue they may have with coding. Other than that, there's nothing new mentioned in the notes, and Apple has not been really good about updating notes for the iPhone, the iPad, the watch, or any of those other things as well. Now, along with this update, Apple also pushed beta updates for iPadOS along with iOS, which is basically the same thing. And then they also pushed beta updates for the Apple Watch along with macOS as well. So expect all of those updates with Apple TV and things like that. And those are very small updates, but once macOS comes out, expect a video on the final version of that and watchOS if there's anything new. Now, other than that, as far as new things in this update, nothing really new that you can see as far as features, but if you didn't see my beta 2 follow-up video, there were 2 new things that were mentioned. The first one has to do with Apple TV and that app. So let me go into that. And if I go into the Apple TV app and you go to a show that you've already watched, it will now say play it again. That was there with beta 2, but if you didn't see the follow-up, you wouldn't be aware of that. Now, other than the play it again button, that's not really anything very exciting. They did add a toggle for network location services. So if I go to settings and then I go to privacy, then I go to location services, go all the way down to system services, you'll see there's networking and wireless. And this was there in the code in the previous beta, but I didn't mention it because the physical button wasn't there. So I had a friend that actually found it in the code, and then it popped up for Brandon Butch, a friend of mine, and it just showed up all of a sudden. So it wasn't there initially, and now it is. And you'll see if you try and turn it off, it says turning off location for networking and wireless may affect Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and ultra wideband performance. So this is that toggle for ultra wideband and some other things that are related to networking specifically. Now, as far as other updates, there is a modem update, a modem firmware update. And if you're wondering where you can see that yourself, the modem firmware is at least on the iPhone 11, the 11 Pro, and the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So if you're wondering where to see that, you can go to settings, then you can go down to general, then you go to about, and if you scroll down a little bit where it says Wi-Fi address and Bluetooth, you'll see modem firmware. And this one is 1.04.06. And that particular modem update is 0.01 newer than the last. And so this is significant to me, but I noticed immediate speed improvements when it came to LTE. So if I go to Google, we'll go back to the Apple website. Maybe we'll take a look at iPad. You'll see how fast it's loading. We'll go to this one. Nice and fast, and I only have 2 bars. So even with lesser signal, things seem to be nice and fast. I did initially have an issue when switching from Wi-Fi to LTE, but after the first time, I've had no issues whatsoever. So it must just be this phone. It had to kind of reset those settings, and now it's working better than it's ever worked. So hopefully it stays working like that, and I've been really impressed with it so far. As far as overall performance on all of these devices, well, as far as the iPhone 6S Plus, which is the oldest phone, it's been really quite good. The performance has been great. And the funny thing is the Geekbench isn't as great as the previous time. And I'll show you that in a moment. But performance and smoothness seems to have been refined in this update. So if I go to settings, it's nice and fast, open weather, go back to settings, go back home, go back to music. Everything is loading super fast. So that's a really nice thing to see. Now in a moment, I'll talk about RAM management, but let's first talk about battery life. So if we go into settings, I'll go back to battery. You'll see battery health for me as 100%. Now this is my main used phone, and I've talked more about that at length, but battery health is not affected by the update. It's just rechecking the battery health. So it won't go down from the update. It's just rechecking what the actual physical battery capacity is. Now, as far as my last 10 days, we'll go to the current day. You'll see screen on time is 3 hours and 12 minutes, 33 minutes of screen off time. And I've used about 30 to 40% of my battery. And it's actually doing pretty well. It's not outstanding. Depending on the day, it varies. But normally I would say anywhere from 10 to 12 hours of screen on time on the largest phone, depending on what you're doing. Now, if you're not using it very much, you're just listening to music, those times are going to go up quite a bit. But battery life is much better on 13.3.1 betas than it is 13.3. And about 95% of people in the follow-ups and everything else say the exact same thing. Now, as far as the iPhone XR, well, the XR has had issues overseas as far as carriers with it dropping off carrier signals. So I'm not sure if this is updated and fixed or not, but if you have an iPhone XR, expect it to hopefully be fixed in these updates where it was dropping signal on carriers such as Orange or O2. I'm not sure which ones, but if you're on those carriers, I would love to hear from you. It's specific to the XR though. And performance on the XR is great. Everything seems to be good across all iOS devices, including iPhone 7. So we'll see in future follow-up videos, but right now it's pretty good. Now, as far as iPad OS, nothing is new. Don't expect any changes. It's the exact same changes that you get with the iPhone. And actually, I put iOS 13.3.1 beta 3 on this because I was really sick of small, weird issues I was having with things like YouTube. So every time I'd go to YouTube, I'd load something. It was super slow, but so far it's smooth and not very choppy. But don't expect anything new as far as iPad OS with these particular updates. Now, as far as RAM management, I did a test this time where I opened 20 different applications. Then I let the phone sit for about 2 minutes to 3 minutes and then picked it up and then tried to open YouTube and see if it reloaded. And it didn't. It was actually quite good. I found that I could open all the way up to about 30 applications. So going back into music, going to weather, going to the App Store, and you'll see the App Store just reloaded a little bit. So up to about 30 times, then it will reload, even if you let it sit. So I'm finding that around 20 times is no issue. So you definitely can multitask better with this beta, at least compared to what others were saying with beta 2. So hopefully that's improved for you. And if it isn't, let me know in the comments below. Now, as far as benchmarks are concerned, the benchmarks are a little bit funny this time. I ran it twice on the 11 Pro Max, and I've run it on all these devices so you could see that as well. But I scored 1,332, and the other time I scored 1,333. Now, for multi-core, this time around, I scored 3,333. On the previous time I ran through this, I actually scored a little bit higher with 3,374. So the performance feels much faster, but the scores are actually a little bit lower compared to the previous time. So if you look at January 8th or 14th right here, you'll see it's a little bit different. So just depends. It's close enough that you shouldn't really notice any difference. In fact, I would say you're probably going to notice that it's faster. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench on all of these devices. Now on the far left, I have the iPad Pro from 2018. Then I have the iPhone 6S Plus, which has numbers that are a little bit lower, but usually after you use this, it does things in the background. These numbers bump up a little bit. Then I have the iPhone XR and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So this should give you an idea of what your devices will get from the oldest supported devices to the in-between and the newest. Now with this particular update, I thought we'd already have a final version out, but it looks like we may have a final version next week or the following week. So I wouldn't really expect beta 4. I would expect more along the lines of a final release. And then before February, or maybe the first week of February, we'll see iOS 13.4 with hopefully some new features tweaks and changes. And then I'm looking most forward to iOS 14 in June. So expect those things. I also did a video about iPhone SE 2 as well as, or iPhone 9, depending on what you want to call it, and the new iPad that we should see this year later on. So I'm excited for all of those things. Let me know what you're most excited about this year. And of course, if you've installed this beta, let me know how it is for you in the comments below. Be sure to check back for the follow-up I run later in the week. And if you want to see more of these videos, I have playlists and things like that specific to all of these iOS updates. And I'll link all of that in the description below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.